A very good evening to all of you, and today we will discuss the Acanthaceae family. This is popularly known as the Acanthus family. This family is recognized with the number of 256 species, and 2,765 species has been recognized. This is a Adatoda family. This is a Adulsa family. This is a Hygrophila is also the example. Acanthus also belongs to this family. This family is also commonly known as the Barlalia family. According to the Bentham and Hooker, the classification is Dicotyledons, Gamopetalae, Bicarpellidae, as well as the Persoonales. This is a 256 genera, and 2,765 species has been recognized into the tropical part of the world. The four centers of distribution are Indo-Malaysia, Africa, Brazil, and Central Africa. In India, family is represented by 68 genera, and 340 species has been recognized. The best example may be Thunbergia species, which is known as the clockvine, Justicia adatoda. Adatoda is also known as the Wasaka, and also some other examples are also been there. This is a structure which is showing the Adatoda gileanica. This you can observe that into the floral diagram. The flower stamen, as well as the carpels, as well as the longitudinal cuts, has also been shown in this figure. This is the another plant which belongs to this family is Peristopi. And so before talking about the very interesting aspects of this family, so this family is known as the Barlalia family, Acanthus family. This family is Adatoda, which is known as the leaves and roots are dry, which are used in bronchitis as well as asthma. The Barlalia are used as leaf and roots are used, or Barlalia are used as inflammatory. They are derived from Sclerophoriaceae family. They are homologous to Boraginaceae as well as the Sclerophoriaceae family. So this vegetative structure is this is an annual or perennial herb, undershrub or shrub, or sometime climbing as a species of Thunbergia as well as the Mendonica. They are generally inhabited damp and marshy places, and some of them are xerophytic. So before going to this is a common regions where you can find this Acanthaceae family is Africa, Brazil, Central America, Indomalaya. 256 genera, and 2,765 species has been recognized. The very interesting features of this family are inflorescences, racemos as well as the cymose, herbaceous plants or shrubby with branches swollen at the nodes. The presence of the swollen nodes has also been there. Leaves are simple, opposite, axis-stipulate leaves are there. The flower is zygomorphic, bisexual with bracts. The petal is bilabiate. So this is another interesting point. The stamen is 4. Didynamous condition has been recognized. Epipetalous condition has also been recognized. The carpel number is 2. Ovary superior exile placentation is there. The exile placentation is exile margin of the exile has been developed by the carpels, folding inwards, fusing together at the center of the ovary to form a single central placenta. Ovary is divided to as many as carpel. So didynamous means the 2 plus 2, 2 small, 2 large. So didynamous condition of stamens has been recognized. So 4 stamens are there, 2 plus 2, 2 small, 2 large. The floral formula is zygomorphic, hermaphrodite, K5 fuse, C5 fuse, A epipetalous condition, 2 plus 2, G2 syncarpus, superior ovary is there. So in this case, the fruit is usually a loculoidal capsule fruit is there. The seeds are, in this case, are ovoid or compressed, non-endospermic, as well as the, with a large embryo has been recognized. So this is a floral formula, floral diagram of Adatoda. The flowers of Acanthaceae is pollinated by the insect, which visit them into the nectar secreted hypogonous disc is there. So insect pollination is an important feature of this family. This is a structure which you can identify floral formula. This family is also used as in ornamental as well as the medicinal one. So some of them are ornamental plants has also been there. These are Thunbergia, which is called the clockvine. This is a erythemum. Another one is there, Jacobinia, Belloperona. The many species of Barlalia has also been used. Strobilanthus also been used as ornamental one. Ruilia, and also the Ginandrus also been used as a ornamental one. So some of them are used as a medicinal one, utilities with there. For example, the Adatoda zilanica, as we just talked into the initial one, they are known as for bronchitis, asthma and cough. The root and leaves of Hygrophila spinosa are used for jaundice and rheumatism. The leaves and roots of several species of Bartleria are also been used as calabasa, which is called the calabasa, is used for cough and inflammation. So this systematically, family, which we are calling the Acanthaceae family, they are Madonica and Giletiella and Thunbergia and Pseudocalyx, Mayenia and Pauguia are placed in separate family. Mendocinia as well as the Thunbergianaceae respectively by Airy as well as the Saw. The family is generally considered to have been derived from Scleroforaceae or stock ancestral to them. So in Acanthaceae family, which we are calling the Acanthus family, which is commonly known as the Bartleria family, and this family is also having the ornamental uses as well as the medicinal uses. But very interesting one is that in this case, the inflorescence is racemose as well as the cymose, the herbaceous plant with shrubby with branch with swollen nodes. The leaves are simple, opposite axis stipulate condition is there. Flower is zygomorphic, bisexual with bracts. Petals are bilabiate, stamens are 4, didymus condition is there, epipetalous is there. The number of carpels are 2, ovary superior, axillary placentation is there. And this, in this case, the flower formula is zygomorphic, hermaphrodite, K5, fuse, C5 fuse, A2 plus 2, didymus condition is there, epipetalous condition is there, G2, syncarpus, superior ovary is there. So best example may be the Bartleria, the best example may be the Astracalentha longifolia, the best example may be the Dicleptera, also belongs to this family. Adatoda also belongs to this family. So this is all about the family which we are calling the Acanthaceae family. Thank you. Thank you very much.